So I was told from a source that the Browns, they want to figure out the coach first and then figure out the general manager. So they're going to go through their interviews. They want their head coach to have significant say in who the GM is because they want them to have a connection, a synergy. So they believe they have a chance at Josh McDaniels. If he's your guy, you can bring him in and say, we want somebody who works well with you. We want to make this work. We're tired of the change. But the mood was crazy because I was talking to people there on Monday, and it's like, we're fed up, man. Like, what do we do now? We're part of a John Dorsey regime that we brought in a lot of good players, star players. This roster probably should have been 9-7 at least with a competent head coach, but there was a power struggle like there is every year in Cleveland.
Mike, when you look at this, what am I missing from John Dorsey? Because he did draft Baker Mayfield, who set the record for rookie touchdowns. He goes against 2,000-yard receivers. And yet he's only given 2 years. What am I missing?
No, that's a fair point. And this team won 13 games over the last 2 years. And, Taylor, to your point, the cupboard is not bare. There's a lot of foundational pieces now. The offensive line really needs to be repaired. And if I'm the new head coach coming in, I want assurances. I want a long-term deal that I want to make progress in 2020. Maybe the playoffs, maybe not. But more importantly, we need stability, and we need to make progress. So if I'm Josh McDaniels or whomever else they're looking at, I want a long-term deal, and I need to know that we're going to blow that graphic away, that we're going to be standing shoulder to shoulder for the next 3, 5, 7 years because we have good pieces in place. Now we need time to build the lines, and those things don't happen overnight.
Yeah, just to clarify, the 1999s when the Browns returned to the NFL, the Haslam family took over in 2012. Ryan, you and those two knuckleheads over there, you tell me what to make of the Cleveland Browns.
You come say it to my face,
no, he's
Taylor.
I said it to your face.
Later. Don't lose your voice.
Soccer player.
Go Terps.
It's already getting started. That's what the new year brings. All right, so, Neek, do you think they should have let Dorsey go?
I mean, I guess if they're not all aligned, you move on from Dorsey. I think it's hard to argue. I mean, we didn't even mention Chubb. He brought in Chubb. It's hard to argue with the decisions that he's made, with the war chest that Sashi Brown built up. He's allocated it well. But there's one major decision on his resume that could get you fired. He hired Freddie Kitchens.
But look at these players. Isn't it the job of the GM to bring in this quality of
good
talent?
Job. But he also took a tight ends coach and said, I'm going to hand this over to you. And it was a mess. So, I mean, that's one thing I can point to and say it's worth getting rid of a guy over that.
I don't know if that's enough to get him by. You know, I mean, he made so many other good decisions. He gave Cleveland instant credibility. He gave him instant credibility where it made free agents want to go there. I mean, we were picking him as a potential playoff contender, maybe a Super Bowl contender. And I think really they went out and got all these shiny pieces, forgot where championships are won in the trenches. They used to have one of the best offensive lines in the business. You know, they traded that away for pass rushers, for Odell Beckham, and I think maybe that's the case. But he's done a tremendous job in creating some tremendous fundamental pieces there, and he was the adult in the room. He gave him credibility. He also brought over Kareem Hunt, and I know that was a controversial piece, but he was a playmaker.
But part of him being the adult in the room was he wanted to be the only adult in the room, because the speculation was he hired Freddie Kitchens in part because he could control him. So that power-hungry stuff, like, I understand all the decisions he made, but that backfired.
I don't think it was because he hired Freddie Kitchens, because Baker Mayfield was flourishing underneath him, and too often we cater to these quarterbacks and what they decide, what they want. I mean, that's why Adam Gase is there with Sam Darnold, because they have the same agent and because he made him feel good. You got to get leaders of men. I think they let the wrong coordinator out of the building. They should have kept Greg Williams, who proved in New York that he can, coach up lesser talent to perform at
a
high level.
So you're saying they have to get leaders of men. Let's spin it forward. Dorsey's out. Presumably the guy coming in is going to run the whole thing.
Yeah.
What kind of coach needs to come in there right now?
Well, for me, I think you need that general manager / head coach. So I'm going Mike McCarthy. I think they flirted with him a little bit. He already has his team assembled. He's a guy that has the credibility instantly when he walks in that room. He's not some fancy coordinator.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports, more analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.